Hello. If you are thinking of making an FM transmitter, your search is over here. This is a fully working FM transmitter circuit, 1 watt, 2 kilometers range, guaranteed with crystal clear sound. The circuit looks like this. And if you look at the components which are required is this way. We got the transistors, the resistors, capacitors, you can note them down, and the coil, finally the other components like trimmer, mic, coaxial cable, antenna is a GP antenna, ground plane antenna, and that's how it starts giving about guaranteed 2 kilometers range. You can even get more than 2 kilometers using a Zyagi antenna, that is a directional antenna. Otherwise, with GP antenna, it's 2 kilometer diameter, even if it is kept inside the house. So this is what is the transmitter. But let me tell you, if you are trying to assemble this, it's not an easy job. If you are a hobbyist, if you are a beginner, you will have frustrating experience. I am not going to scare you for this, but the reason behind this, these are all high frequency device, high frequency operation. In the process, slightest mistake or slight layout mistake or slight soldering mistake will drastically reduce its range in particular, and then there are chances that the components might get damaged too. So this is what is the precaution that one has to take if you would like to assemble such kind of transmitter. Let me explain you the function of this. We have a microphone here, and then the microphone, of course, since it's a condenser microphone, we have a resistor biasing the microphone, and then with the capacitor we feed it to a transistor. This transistor, in fact, is a dual function. This also is an oscillator transistor, where an L and C is made here. The L and C forces this transistor to oscillate at that particular frequency, which is set by this trimmer. And this trimmer could be about 22 pf, and we can adjust that frequency, or even increasing the spacing between the coils, in the coil, that is the spacing also. Then the output from here is given to another transistor. This is the buffer transistor. What we do is the amplification of whatever frequency modulation takes place through this audio here, and that is finally sent to another power amplifier, which is ultimately delivering the power to a tuned circuit comprising of this kind of L and this kind of C and the trimmer and all. You'll be surprised as to why so many capacitors are used in the positive and negative rail. This is because this being very high frequency operation, and particularly the FM range is from 88 megahertz to 108 megahertz. So you can adjust that frequency anywhere by this, and the range can be adjusted by this. One can use some kind of meter, some kind of field strength meter, to see that the range is achieved to the maximum that is required or that is possible. So the biggest advantage of this is that if you use a GP antenna, you get quite a long range. GP antenna is ground plane antenna, and it can be fabricated. The details also will be given at a later date in the audiovisual again. Look at the assembled PCB here. We have the space for the microphone here, which could be connected to some cabinet, which we'll see it later. This is the capacitor for that condenser microphone, and this is the biasing resistor for that. The first transistor that oscillation takes place here. This is the first coil, and this is the trimmer, And then we have a tapping which is taken from here and then given to the second transistor. This is the second transistor, and these are certain capacitors, as we said, that has to be connected for decoupling the power supply. Then we have the next coil and the other arrangements which is there in the circuit. You can see the number and you can correlate with that. And then finally, the power transistor here. The power transistor is provided with a heat sink. The reason being that the heat sink is imperative here because there is a lot of power which is going to be handled by this, in particular when we feed it from a 12 volt source. And then we have the last coil for the power device, power transistor here. And then of course there is the tuned circuit where we have one more L and then the trimmer and of course the other decoupling requirement for the circuit. So this is how the printed circuit board looks like. And we will see how you put it in a box so that we get it the good finish of this. This is how we put it inside a box. The power on switch, we have an LED indication for whether it is switched on or not. Then we have two inputs here, one for the microphone and one for the auxiliary input, which could be fed from any computer or any audio device for music or whatever requirement the one has. This is how it looked like from the rear end. In the rear end we have the antenna, which is meant for a coaxial cable, as we say. The GP antenna will be seen at a later time, and then the socket for the GP antenna here. We have an arrangement here with an LED and a switch. A switch is provided for test purpose, that at the point when you would like to test it, switch it on, see that light is glowing, because this is the power delivery, RF power delivery indication. And once you are satisfied that the RF power is adequate, and then you can put it up to the antenna mode and it starts radiating power. This is the DC socket where we provide about 12 volt supply requirement for the device. The power consumption is less than 100 milliamperes, and one can jolly well use about say 500 milliampere or so DC source. And finally, the GP antenna, as we said, the ground plane antenna, which is again fabricated. We take some angle irons, aluminium, it's not never iron, it's always aluminium, angle aluminium. And then we have a plate here, we have some arrangement here, we have another rod type aluminium, and a coaxial cable is connected to the device, as we have seen earlier. And that's how the whole system is complete. As I told you before, that it's a device of very high frequency. If you are a beginner and if you try to attempt this, perhaps the success rate will be very, 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 very poor. So it's advisable. It's not that I'm going to sell a product, but it's advisable that you buy this product and to get rid of all the problem of hassles of not getting the output as required. The product is also supplied with other accessories like an FM radio, which look like this, with a battery backup for about 12 hours battery backup. An adapter, AC adapter, from 100 volts AC to 230 volt AC, delivering 12 volt DC, about 1 ampere power, but requirement of course is very low, but this is for a safety. Also supplied along with a microphone, with the mono microphone for use with the device.